Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Greg, and I only have a few seconds to grab your attention. I could do it through humor, I could do it through fear, or I could do it through information. So let's start with a little bit of information first. Right now, in your brain, there are billions of cells called neurons, and they're talking back and forth with each other. It's like a network. Like the internet, sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's slow, sometimes it doesn't work. Other times it's faster than you can handle. And there's one molecule in particular that controls the speed and the strength of that communication. And that molecule is called dopamine. Now, dopamine, it motivates us to work for a reward. Like, what kind of work? Love. Shelter, food, something new. So just think about when you're hanging out with your friends, right? You guys are having fun, laughing, joking. Maybe you have a crush on somebody, as I know people do. You're eating chocolate. Maybe you see a funny image. That is the dopamine feel-good effect, right? So dopamine's involved in motivation, our mood, our memory, our movement. It's pretty important, right? But if it sounds so good, if dopamine sounds so good, can it be bad? Now comes the fear. In today's highly connected digital world, dopamine can actually work against us. Because dopamine drives us towards a goal, but what are those goals? Does this look familiar? It's 10 o'clock, you have school tomorrow, right? You're scrolling and you're scrolling. You're craving more, you want one more image, just one more song, one more reel. Then it's 11 o'clock, you have a test tomorrow. I do. You're getting anxious, you're starting to get FOMO. Why is this still one checklist here? Why hasn't my friend messaged me back? You're starting to get depressed. This can actually lead to low self-esteem and poor decision-making. And then you look at your clock and you're like, where did the time go? But you know what? What if I told you that if you learn how to manage your time, you can reward your mind. And you can reward that with your own dopamine. Here's the cool part. So repeat after me. Reward for free is my enemy. Ready? Reward for free is my enemy. What does that mean, Dr. Greg? Glad you asked, Catherine. Let's build a time machine. Our ancient ancestors, they had to hunt for food. They had to evade the tiger and not get eaten. That was motivated through dopamine. Through dopamine, they learn how to farm, they learn how to cultivate crops. They wanted to stay alive. Just being alive was the reward. And in doing so, they actually created the first social network. Now, in other times when Dr. Greg was a teenager, ancient, in the 80s, I would have to buy cassette tapes, right? I would have to wait and listen for the song to come on the radio. And as I did, my dopamine would start building and building and building. And then when I heard the song, boom, my dopamine would go up. And then it would come down. And then I would have to wait for another song, or I'd have to chatty another cassette. I have to get some more cassettes so I can feel good again. And then an hour would go by, 2 hours would go by, and then I'd look at my swatch, and then, oh my gosh. Where did the time go, right? Because now, in 2025, right now, reward for free, it's at our fingertips. It's easy. It's too easy. We don't have to work for it. With the swipe of glass, boom, you're on Spotify. You get your favorite song. With the swipe of glass, you can message somebody on the other side of the world. Everything's instant likes instant me, right? Instant food, instant gratification, instant depression. And yeah, it could get a little dangerous sometimes. And you can feel depressed and you don't know why. So remember this guy? The first time I showed you his image, your dopamine levels, they went up because it was new. It was something you've never seen before. But if I keep showing you this image, yeah, your dopamine will go up, but it's not going to get as high. And you're going to want more stimulation, right? More stimulation. You want some more content. You want something new. What's Dr. Greg going to show me next? And that can become depressing, and your brain can get tired. You're like, I do, pusing. And literally, right here, your brain, your PFC, right here, your prefrontal cortex, this part is really, really active right now, especially when you're on social media. And it's talking to another part of your brain called the amygdala. They're going back and forth, back and forth. And they're involved in mood, anxiety, memory, fear, sleep, your emotions. I mean, these are very, very important things. And when you become addicted, this PFC, it actually gets weak and it gets thinner, more tipis, right? Tipis. And that can lead to a lack of focus. You become introverted, right? Poor decision making. I mean, where's the self-care there? Where's the love for yourself there? And we're all guilty of it. We all do it. But how about like when you're scrolling and you're gaming? Did you know that there's an area of your brain called the somatosensory cortex? And it can respond to like touch. And it can
respond to finger. And right now when you're on social media, that part in a raise, it is really, really active. Now, is this a good thing? We don't know yet. Really don't know what is happening in our brains. And that is the reality. But some of you would actually become brain scientists so you can find out what is going on in our brain. Now, this is TEDx, right? Where the T stands for technology, the E for entertainment, a D for design. This little Denier X, I'll share with you in a few moments what that means. Social media technology companies, they design their products to entertain us. They do it through clever algorithms that keep us online. They reward us with this easy, easy reward. They kind of pick us addicted sometimes, and we don't realize. But it's fantastic, right? Right, everybody's on social media, it has an account, everybody's scrolling. And the first time you're on though, the first hour or so, it's great. But your brain is actually trickier. And it's using dopamine against you to keep you on that device. And it's keeping you from interacting with other people in person, keeping you from study, right? And dopamine, what it's doing is it's creating this addicted cycle, right? It's easy rewards, repeated behaviors, same song on repeat. Now, this is the reality that you live in right now, but we shouldn't be afraid of technology. We should embrace it because it's not going anywhere. It's only gonna get faster and it's only gonna get more powerful. So what you can do, and this is the greatest part, is that you're in control. Everybody here is in control. And that's where I have hope for this generation and for the next generation. You are in control. And did you know that you could hack the lump dopamine? And the cool part is, many of you are already doing it. Especially my daughter, she's working out. Here's a tip. Who checks the phone as soon as you wake up? All right? Guilty. Yeah, don't be shy. Everybody does. So how about this? How about the first 15 minutes of the day, get some sunlight, go to view. And what do you do? What happens is the sun, when it hits your eye, is actually a molecule in there that gets triggered. And that naturally increases the dopamine.
So get some sunlight. If it's still too early because you wake up to pray, the greatest part of that is that prayer and meditation, those actually raise dopamine levels. And if it's still dark outside, try a quick 3-minute shower. Cold water, that will boost your dopamine. And it's natural, it's inside you. It'll naturally get you going. You can even do this after an exercise. You can do some push-ups, right? You do some running in place. You can clean your room, right, Catherine? Now this one right here, this is the hardest one. And I challenge everyone to try it. For 15 minutes, do nothing. Just do nothing. Just quiet your brain, quiet your mind. Watch yourself breathe in air. And just appreciate being alive, because that's self-care. That's you. You're in control of that. And you have the power to do that. No one else, just you. Now these digital dopamine puasa steps, I mean, it's back to basic hacks to prepare your brain for the next reward. Now there's one in particular I haven't mentioned. Can anyone guess? Soon, the holy month of Ramadan will begin. And did you know when you puasa and when you fast, your brain is getting more sensitive to dopamine? So just imagine, you hear the call to prayer, have that first drink of water, that first bite. Wow, luar biasa. It's amazing, right? That felt good. That is dopamine's natural effect. And you did that to yourself. You're in control. You have the power. You have the power to make yourself feel that way, to feel beautiful inside. That's powerful. But what about later when you're playing block bass, right? You're scrolling, because it will happen. Guilty, right? We all do it. This is important. This is very, very important. If anything comes away from this talk, learn how to ask yourself, how do I feel? How do I feel? Only you know yourself. Only you know yourself, what's inside your heart. Ask yourself, how do I feel? And if you don't feel good, just put the phone away, you know. Let it charge. And in that time, you can journal. You can read a book. You can talk to other people. You can clean your room. You can clean your environment. Because the people around you will absolutely love you and respect you for that. And you know what? When you care for others, when you're sayang with your family, when you're sayang with your friends, that is self-care right there. Exactly, right there. That's self-care. And that boosts dopamine. That's natural. You can do that by yourself. Because that is the key. And it's through self-discipline and good habits. But you know what? Self-discipline, here's a secret. Self-discipline, it's harder than math and science, I guarantee you. But it's a process. And if you stick with it, if you work at it, the reward will pay off in the long run. So remember, give your PFC some TLC, some tender loving care, okay? Because when you take control of your dopamine, you will have better memory. You'll be in a much better mood. There you go. I like that. Yes. Because that right there, that's going to motivate you to eat better. That's going to motivate you to be a better person. That's going to be motivating you to volunteer, to do better in school. And most importantly, that dopamine is going to encourage you and motivate you to love one another. And that's what we really need right now. We need love. And we need a lot of self-respect. Now for the Demure X. Here comes the anticipation. It's building, right? So what does this small X mean? It's a big message, and it's specifically for you. Expect to change the world, okay? Expect to change the world. Expect to change your world. And you can do it. I know you can do it. You have the power to do it. Because when you learn how to master your mind, you will master your future. My name is Dr. Greg, and it has been such a reward. Terima kasih.